Hi, my name is Peter from Urender. In this video, I will show you how to work with Substances and Urender. First, let's create a little scene. I like to use the landscape with deactivated borders at sea level. Then create a null and a spotlight. Parent and move the spotlight along the z-axis. Increase the outer angle of the spotlight and create a U-Render light tag. Go to the render settings and select U-Render as render device. I recommend to set a global HDR environment map and to activate enable diffuse IPL. This gives a good starting point of overall indirect lighting and reflection. Leave all other settings for now and just start U-Render live to see what we've got so far. I set the shadow mode to soft shadows and adjust the angle of the spotlight null. So that's our scene and it really could need a nice ground material. You can find very nice substances on Substance Source. For this example, I will use the rubble sand substance. Just download it and copy it into your project folder. Back in Cinema, load the substance and open the downloaded SBSAR file. All substances that are loaded into your project are listed in this Substance Asset Manager. In the Attribute Manager, you can see all values and parameters that are exposed by the substance. By default, the resolution is set to a very low value, but we will change that later. You may have noticed that by loading the substance, there is also a cinema material created automatically. There are three kinds of cinema materials you can create within the Substance Asset Manager: standard, metallic, and glossy. By default, the already created material is a metallic one. If you want to convert this cinema material to a U-Render material, I recommend to use the glossy version. Assign the material to the landscape and adjust the UV tiling. I will also increase the intensity of the spotlight. This is the fastest way to get a proper result, but let's have a closer look to the converted material. In the texture channels are substance shaders assigned. If you open it, you can select every channel that the substance provides. What I don't like so much is that the glossiness has an additional colorizer node, because the created Cinema 4D material uses the colorizer to invert the glossiness map to behave as a roughness map. This works, but it's unnecessarily complex. The texture looks unsharp, and that's because the default resolution of the substance is set to a very low resolution, so let's increase it a little bit. As we used to bake Cinema 4D shaders, and Substance Shader is one of them, it is also important to set up the baking resolution for the texture channels. You can set different resolutions for each channel. As I already mentioned, this is the fastest way to get substances U-Render ready. If you want to set them up by hand, you simply can create a new U-Render material and set the substance shader as needed. Put the substance shader into the channel and use the pick mode cursor to click on the substance in the Asset Manager. Right-click and copy the channel, paste wherever you need it and select the desired channel. Note that you should use diffuse and specular texture or base color and metallic texture to get the correct result. For the normal map, I will turn off U-Render Live for a moment to get a material preview. There are two different kinds of normal maps, OpenGL and DirectX normal maps. The difference between them is the Y direction. OpenGL Y direction is facing upwards and DirectX Y is facing downwards. By default, the substance is set to DirectX normal map. U-Render needs OpenGL normal maps, so you have to change the normal format in the substance to OpenGL, or you also can check the Flip Y option in the material. If you want to use displacement maps, use the substance height channel. Assign the material and adjust the tiling and activate the displacement in the render settings. Adjust the amount of displacement with the strength or height values and check if you need more subdivision levels to get a good result. Of course, too high values costs performance, so it's a good idea to keep that values as low as possible. Let's further increase the scene by just tweaking a couple of things. First, create a camera so we can add some depth of field to the scene. In this scene, you don't need to set a near clipping plane. In some edge cases, this can prevent flickering artifacts. To get depth of field, you have to enable it first in the render settings. With the focus distance and f-stop, you can adjust the depth of field as you like. Next, I turn on the ambient occlusion and increase the radius as well as the power. A little bit of bloom with a large radius is sometimes useful to slightly add additional luminance. A bright bluish fog adds depth to the scene. Let's add tone mapping and also use it to brighten up the entire result. Chromatic aberration and vignette gives a little bit of photo-like style. So, with just a few additional render settings, we greatly increase the render result. The great thing about working with substances and U-Render is that you get all changes instantly in real time in high quality. Some substances have custom features that can change the appearance dramatically, so it's a great fun to work with them. So, thanks for watching and have fun with substances and U-Render.